Here's some advice. The tough stuff, don't deal with it right now. Deal with the easy stuff. Always the easy stuff is what you want to do. What you want to take care of is the easy stuff, not the difficult stuff. The difficult stuff is what trips you up, because actually truth is very easy, very simple. So what I've been doing recently is, when all these questions arise in my mind and how to answer those questions, I say, that's too tough. I want to stick with the simple stuff. And it disappears like that. So that's a great technique to use to save you an unbelievable amount of suffering. Because the whole situation is so easy, so simple. Just said, let me get that first, and then we'll deal with all these tricky questions that you hear, in satsang. These questions come up that are like so, really very tricky questions. The ego's an expert in asking tricky questions. And you say, I'm not really prepared to deal with those really tricky questions. I'm not there yet. So all I can do is deal with the simple stuff. That's humility. It saves time for you, protects you from all sorts of troubles. So what is existence that we are experiencing? It is an opinion. It's an opinion about reality. It is an opinion about reality. It is not reality. Here's another fact, that no opinion about reality is true whatsoever. They're all equally meaningless. Reality cannot be reduced to an opinion or a perspective or a perception. All perception, all perspectives, all concepts, all opinions, all the same. They're equally meaningless. Equally meaningless. Existence is really an opinion about how do we accomplish the impossible? And there's these infinite opinions that the mind is presenting. Okay, this body mind is an opinion that mind has generated. All right, and spirit is identifying with this, with a particular body mind opinion, thinking like, well, maybe this opinion has something important, valuable. You know, maybe it could be valuable to identify with this. There's no value at all in opinions. No value, zero value, zero. Now, what we are after is the final opinion that makes all other opinions unnecessary. And that's also has no real value, okay? It comes from the Holy Spirit. The grace of God has an opinion about reality, but that opinion about reality is so beautiful that we say, you know what, this reminds me of something. And so it solves the continuity issue. Whereas the other opinions that we have cannot remind us about reality at all. So as a matter of fact, the opinions that mind is generating, because of course we want to be prime creator, we want to be greater than reality. So all we can do is have these opinions like, yeah, this is how you do it. This is how you do it. I think this is the way. This is the way. This is what reality is really going to be like or is like. Just opinions. Denying reality. Denying what it is. So the Holy Spirit makes something so beautiful, it reminds us of reality. But this world here does not remind us. The opinions that we're seeing as people, persons, things, experiences, etc., perceptions, concepts, doesn't remind us of reality in any way. Not even in the slightest way does it remind us of reality. It is so completely off track, so utterly, capriciously, whimsically off track, that how in the world can we be reminded of reality? You know, we have this terrible continuity problem, because this has absolutely nothing to do with reality. The idea that reality is some mechanical, biomechanical body sensing things walking on this earth, you know, and getting food to shelter to survive, and perceiving things into the senses. The idea that that has something to do with reality is just completely absurd. Nothing to do with it. This is just utterly off track. And there is the continuity problem. There is a continuity problem. How do we, you know, drop these opinions when they're so off track and we're used to being so just absolutely loopy? This is just completely loopy. The mind is just generating the most capricious stuff imaginable. that reality is some reification of things that are attacking each other, and just to survive, they camouflaging and sneaking up and attacking all the creatures and animals and insects, etc. And the plants growing, dying, every dust getting reified into forms and then crumbling back, you know, and all this nonsense. Completely preposterous, utterly preposterous. Absolutely nothing to do with anything whatsoever, except just complete whimsical opinion that we've just devised this maniacal fantasy of what reality is, an opinion of this is what reality is. Again, nothing to do with reality at all. So we have this gigantic continuity problem. How do we resolve it? The Holy Spirit resolves it. God created the Holy Spirit specifically to resolve this problem for us because it's such a huge problem. So if you just start out each day and remind yourself, I have a severe continuity problem. It's so severe, it's unbelievably severe. Now, how does the Holy Spirit do this? It is able to have an opinion, present an opinion to us about reality, which is what we're used to. We're used to entertaining an opinion about reality. That's what we're doing. When we have a body, we say, I have a body, what we're really doing is we're entertaining an opinion about reality. That's what the whole body mind in this world is. It's just an opinion, and we're entertaining it. We're saying, come on in, sit down, and let me watch your antics, you know. It's got nothing to do with reality, nothing to do with spirit. But we're used to entertaining opinions about reality. So what does the Holy Spirit do? We invite it in also into our house and say, Holy Spirit, I want you to show me your opinion of reality. It's that simple. And say, the other opinion, you know, I'm tired of it. I want to get a different perspective. And so let's see what your opinion is of reality. That's pretty much it. And then we get Holy Spirit's opinion of reality. Just an opinion. Holy Spirit knows it's just an opinion. It's not really reality, but it reminds us of reality. And it's something like so beautiful. Everything looks so sublime, equally sublime. It's called unified vision or same vision, vision of sameness, vision of oneness. Everything has the same quality of beauty, the same depth, the same spaciousness. There's nothing that stands out and nothing that it recedes or shrinks away like, oh, this is ugly, but this is beautiful. So it's called non-relative vision, I would say. Non-relative vision. Now, what we're used to is called relativism. And that is, we see things, we say this is beautiful, but it's always related to something that isn't so beautiful, okay? So it's contingent, like on contrast. That is called duality. It's related. Everything has a value in relation to other everything else. You know, wealth, poverty. All these polar opposites and the play of these polar opposites produce what we think is value. Okay, but when we step away from that and we see this vision of sameness, that's gone. We have a unified view of everything is equally beautiful. So this is very different. Non-relative. We're used to relativity. In our valuing, everything is relative to something else, right? Whereas in this vision of the opinion of the Holy Spirit, nothing is relative to anything else. Everything shares the same qualities. So obviously this is the end of art, the end of what we call creativity, but really that's just the play of relativity that we've been engaged in. Say, look at this beautiful diamond, how beautiful it is in relation relative to a clump of mud or something. But it really, from the standpoint of being reminded of reality, the Holy Spirit shows us that everything's equally same, so that a clump of mud is just as beautiful as the most beautiful diamond. There's no difference in, as far as the beauty goes. So it's a different perspective on the world. Everybody is equally wonderful. Everything is equally wonderful. Everything is equally exquisite. Everything is equally beautiful. So this song or that song, it's all equally beautiful. So this is like a shock to us. We say, oh my gosh, you know, we're not used to thinking in that way. We're used to thinking, well, this song is great, and these others are not as good. And we're used to trying to find what is the best. What are the best clothes, the best jewelry, the best places, the best music, the best food, the best books, the best entertainment, the on and on and on. What is the best friends, etc., etc. But in the Holy Spirit's opinion of reality, all is has the same qualities. Everything has the same qualities. So it's the end of goal-seeking behavior, really, where you're trying to find the best. You found it when the Holy Spirit's opinion of reality, that is the best. That ends your search for the best. And in that, everything is just incredibly exquisite. So again, art is transcended at that point. All these things we're used to is completely arise in relativity, the relativeness of duality. It all arises in duality. So if someone wants to be a great artist, they're basically consigning themselves to the realm of duality and trying to impress others' opinions, about their opinion that they're identifying with, about look how wonderful this artwork is. But in the Holy Spirit's opinion of reality, same. So it's all good. It's all good. There isn't anything that isn't exquisite. That's another way to put it. So it's non-relative. There isn't anything that is any less or more exquisite. Everything's exquisite. Everything shares the same spaciousness, the same qualities. So when we look at it that way, we realize, hey, there really is a big difference between duality and non-duality. And we're super used to duality, right? So when you wonder, why is it so difficult? Why is it taking so long? Because we're super immersed in duality. We're super immersed in trying to basically offer up opinions. The mind trying to work with the mind, saying, the mind's working and saying, let me show you this. Here's another opinion of reality. There's an opinion. Here's a piece of artwork. There's an opinion of reality. Maybe we can make a better opinion, another opinion. And we're totally used to that. Another song, all these songs, just opinions about reality. So the aim of the spiritual path is to decide, you know what, I'm going to go for the Holy Spirit's opinion of reality, in which we experience the sameness. Because ultimately, we have to drop opinions altogether. So, what we need to do that, we have to be reminded of what is reality like, really. And it is this beautiful, exquisite sameness in terms of the basic, intrinsic reality of reality, really. Reality is all qualities are shared with everything that arises in reality. All pure spaciousness. Everything is equally in the pure spaciousness of reality. There is no possibility of something being more or less. That's duality, more and less. And that is what we have been cocooned in this for so long. So we're trying to break out of this cocoon. And for some reason, we're quite resistant to it. We kind of shrink away from doing this. So one has to just continually keep on working at it, just like a career. It's a career thing. It's like a business owner. If you're like a small business owner, you might work like 16-hour days. It's on you. You have to show up in the morning. You got to be there. It's like that. It's like being a small business owner, and it all falls on your shoulders, and you just have to keep working at it, show up every day and work at it. So we're doing that. We're going towards the 21st of December. That's a good, nice date. What happens after that date? Well, what I've been finding is definite, the intensity of breakthroughs is increasing. to get to the point where we say it's just all an opinion, and to see that and begin to recognize it, I'm beginning to sort of dawning on me. Each person I see, I say, wow, that is only an opinion. The body there is just an opinion that mind has made, and spirit is paying attention, just watching that opinion. Well, there aren't any, no such thing as really people at all. They're just opinions. Everything here is just an opinion of mind. And mind is showing these opinions to spirit and saying, spirit, this is what reality is really like. And we say, okay, let's see if we can get used to this. Let's even get used to this. So every life that, quote unquote, we've had in reincarnation, I've had very many, 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 but all of them are simply opinions that mind was presenting. And my spirit was simply saying, well, maybe this is it, or maybe this is it, or maybe this is it, or maybe this is helpful, maybe this is valuable, maybe this can get some value or something. But literally, no one has ever incarnated. Spirit has never incarnated. There's never been any incarnation whatsoever. Zero. Mind is simply producing these decorations called opinions in endless variety and infinite numbers and varieties of just producing these opinions. And so you end the so-called cycles of incarnation, which actually never took place, by realizing they never did take place. They never will take place. Spirit cannot incarnate. It's impossible. Spirit cannot be flesh. Now, you either see duality or you see the singularity, the sameness. You can't see both. You can't see both at the same time. It's impossible. So you either see relative value or you see just one value or just this unified value of everything. Sameness, same value, same valueness. Either see relative valueness or same valueness. Can't see both. Cannot see both at the same time. Can't serve two masters. It's impossible. And we've heard that over and over and over and over and over, and it's very, very true. So when we're getting ready to have same value, we're kind of worried, like, oh, I'm going to lose value because I'm not going to see duality, which all this, relativity, something in contrast to something else. Well, that's not a loss of value. Remember, opinions have no value. Reality is so far beyond opinions that it doesn't matter what opinion you have, it has no value. Pragmatically, is the only value you could possibly have is a pragmatic value, but no actual, meaningful value. Never will. No perception will ever have any actual meaningful value. None. But the Holy Spirit's opinion does have a pragmatic application of reminding us. So, in that way, it's helpful. It's helpful. It's pragmatically helpful, but it still has no actual value or meaning whatsoever. None. So, if nothing, no opinion has any value, why not be pragmatic and accept one that at least is helpful? It's a business decision. It's an easy, no-brainer decision, and look at it that way. You got nothing to lose. You don't have anything in the first place, really. We're not incarnated. Nobody's in spirits. There's nothing is incarnated at all, actually. Mind is presenting all of this stuff as if it were real, but it's all just opinion. And we're not in it. There's nothing in it. There's no ghost in the machine. There is not. It's the same way that we watch a movie. We're not in the movie. We're watching the movie. We're not in the movie at all. It doesn't matter what appears on the screen. We're not in the movie. So, same. We're not in the movie. Nobody's in the movie. No one's here, actually. No one's ever been here. There's never been anything here as far as actual meaning in opinions. Opinions are nowhere. They're nothing and they're nowhere. So we've never been born. It's you can see it two ways. Is that yes, we have identified with opinions over and over, but we've never actually been born at all. So we've never even had even one incarnation. No one has. Including, without exception. Spirit can never become an opinion. It's not possible. It can never become flesh, an opinion about reality. Spirit is one with reality. It is reality. It cannot become something else. It's impossible. So we start to shift and change our concepts, the way we value things and look at things and say, wow, it's not really valuable to keep identifying with an opinion, is it? Except that unless it's pragmatically helpful. And since I have a continuity problem, I need pragmatic help. So I might as well just see the world as just exquisitely beautiful. And that's it. It doesn't matter if the whole thing's coming unglued, coming unwound, falling apart. It's all still exquisitely beautiful. You're not judging things in terms of goals anymore. There is no goal to reach in opinions. There is no goal. All equally, like it's like, why differentiate between opinions of how to accomplish the impossible, which is what we're entertaining, opinions about how to accomplish the impossible. What value does any of those opinions have, really? None. This one, here's an opinion about accomplishing impossible. Well, there's one over there. Oh, there's another opinion. Oh, I see a lot of opinions here about how to accomplish impossible. Why spend any time trying to differentiate between those? Just meaningless, completely meaningless. So we're just we're just watching this meaningless movie, really. Not even engaged in it, actually. It's this movie is being presented, and we're just sort of passively aware of it. That's it. So as we go towards the 21st, these are the days that are difficult, but we're getting through. I think tomorrow was like the 20th, right? And I've tried to stay with good habits and doing a pretty good job of that. And just keep on keeping on. And keep on bringing the truth to light, and I find that the light is getting clearer and clearer and clearer. And of course, if there is a return of quote-unquote Jesus or various situations arrive for the purpose of relocation, then that will happen. If it happens, it happens. It either will or it won't. But it doesn't change the truth in the slightest bit about what we're talking about here. It doesn't change that at all. So again, stick with the simple stuff. That's what I'm seeing right now. Just stick with the simple stuff. Don't try to struggle with the difficult stuff, really. It's fun to struggle with it because you think that you're really, you know, doing something, but real at this point in time, actually stick with the simple stuff. Maybe it's a UPS truck delivering packages late at night. Possible, probable, right? It's getting towards Christmas. So hopefully everybody's done whatever they need to do, getting ready for whatever they need to get ready for. But in the meantime, we are focusing on the simple stuff. Okay, so keep your focus on the simple stuff, and you will find that the whole thing keeps lightening up for you. All right.